Hello, my name is Tor Idhammar. I'm working with a company called IDCON Incorporated. We're in Raleigh, North Carolina, and we're a reliability and maintenance consulting firm. So we get a chance to visit quite a few plants around the world, and we want to share some of the experiences here with you. There's quite a bit of videos here. We're trying to add one every couple of weeks or so. Of course, we have a lot of articles on our website, www.idcon.com. So today's topic is maintenance costs. Somebody has come up with this bright idea that your maintenance cost needs to be cut, and it has to happen pretty quick. So let's say you have a maintenance budget of $5 million, and we need to cut it by 5%. So that means that you now have a maintenance budget of $4.75 million this year. Let's talk about that and what we can do. In some cases, we can't do much as manager of maintenance. We just need to do what we're told. But if you're in charge of maintenance and you're in charge of that maintenance cost, I think there's a good opportunity at least to take a discussion if this is the right thing to do for the company. Because the principle of the company should be that, of course, if we cut the maintenance cost and that's the best for the company and we will actually get the results we expect, great. But that's typically not what happens. What typically happens is that we cut the maintenance cost, let's say by 5%, to $4.75 million, and we don't really improve any systems, or we don't improve anything. So therefore, what we have to do is get rid of people, or get rid of contractors, or get rid of overtime that we had last year. So now we have a bunch of repairs that needs to be done, but we don't have the resources to do those repairs. And some people may argue, well, you should become more efficient. And they may very well be right on that, and that's very typical too. However, we can't just become more efficient because somebody screams, become more efficient now with a baseball bat and megaphone, right? So we can't become efficient within just a few months. We're just gonna have to do less maintenance work. And what happens when we do less maintenance work, we have repairs that turns into breakdowns. And when that happens, of course, we have even more problems. So if you look at the slide that we have here, what typically happens is we manage to drive down the cost, and it may go down 5% by reducing whatever resources, and the reliability stays for a while. If you're a not-so-reliable plant or equipment condition is so-so, it may be 5-6 months. If you have pretty good reliability, you may last for 18 months where you don't see a whole lot on reliability. But then after a while, you have this delay effect and the reliability comes down. And now you have breakdowns instead of the maintenance repairs that you could have done in a planned and scheduled fashion from your backlog. Now you have breakdowns instead because we didn't have time to fix these things. And they become a lot more expensive. Typically between 3 to 9 times, depends on, of course, the situation. So in this situation, the costs are going up again. So you have a few options here. So hopefully, one option is to, of course, try to find another job before the cost starts going up again. Or even better, perhaps we should have a discussion about this when the decisions are made. So I think when you hear this, the principle is, of course, that we want to reduce costs as much as possible. Where it's cost beneficial for the company. But if it's not cost beneficial as a whole for the company, we're doing the wrong thing. Because you can argue, if someone comes over 5%, then there's a good plan and a good reasoning for that, because, well, you're building a bunch of stuff that you don't need to be building, or we're doing a bunch of repairs that really doesn't need to be done at all. Okay, fine. But if it's just an assumption, which is very common, that just reduce 5%, and we don't really know if this is going to work or not, but let's just say 5% and cross our fingers and say, and hopefully our results goes down 5%. Well, if that's how we're doing it, why not just say, let's reduce it by 50% to 2.5? Or why don't you just reduce the maintenance cost to 0? Then people say, well, Tor, you're being silly, you're exaggerating. Sure, but because we're reducing a small amount doesn't mean that's the right thing to do either. Maybe we need to increase, if we increase the maintenance cost by 5%, perhaps our total cost comes down because we maintain our equipment better. So I think it's very important that you have a discussion with whoever decided this, that is this really the right thing to do for the company? If it is, very good. Most of the cases I've been into, it's an arbitrary number, and somebody just compared two plants, and they say, okay, we're just going to have to reduce yours cost 5%, and the assumption is, therefore, that it happens to have to happen very quick, and therefore, we do it the wrong way. So if we look at the next graph, the way to do this is, of course, to work on becoming more efficient first. Let's work on becoming better in reliability and maintenance. So we will improve our work processes. We will improve planning and scheduling. Preventing maintenance, how we solve problems with root cause, spare parts management, so we can find our parts very quickly instead of spending time. We have kitting of parts, we have delivery of parts even. And if we work on those work processes, our cost may go up a little bit, because what we're doing is we're really repairing equipment. So we're trying to become better, we're fixing work processes, and we're repairing equipment, we're becoming more reliable. But once we've gone over that little cost hump, then we'll see our costs come down and our reliability go up, and our cost per unit, our total cost per unit, is where the real profit is. So I encourage you, if you're responsible of maintenance, to really have that discussion and not just say, yes sir, yes ma'am, we're just going to cut the cost. I think it's worth a discussion, you know, what are the consequences of cutting the cost? Well, I hope this little snippet has been helpful. There's an article on the same topic around this video somewhere in the description. In some cases is also right together with the video, depending where this is posted. But thank you for your time, and I hope you can subscribe to this and see some more of our videos coming. Thank you.